Now, some of today's other news, and a review of the family justice system has rejected calls for parents to have equal rights to share custody of their children if they separate. The report says that while it is usually in the child's interest to have contact with both parents, seeking to enshrine that right in law would lead to greater conflict and confusion. But groups representing the rights of fathers labelled the report a betrayal. Our social affairs editor Jackie Long has this.
It took Jonathan Stainsby 8 years to win the right to share parenting with his ex-wife. A long, painful court battle that he believes could have been avoided.
It's a ridiculous waste of time, of money, of everything. It was upsetting for everybody involved. And there was no reason. I mean, I'm with the relative child minder. There was no reason why both of us as parents couldn't parent our daughter.
His fight saw him join Fathers for Justice. Here he is scaling Harriet Harman's house. Part of their ongoing campaign was to see the notion of shared parenting written into legislation for cases where couples split, a move ruled out by today's Family Justice Review.
First, a major review into the family laws in England and Wales has recommended fathers who are separating from their partners should not be given the legal right to have access to their children. The report also recommends grandparents' rights should not be enshrined in law either. Katie Fawcett has all the details.
When you kept causing my dad all this trouble, did you ever think of me? Just because I am a child, it doesn't mean I don't have feelings. Can you explain to me how you think any of this has helped me?
Letters to the government from a 13-year-old girl who watched an 8-year custody battle between her parents. Jonathan Stainsby performed a number of stunts to get access to his daughter, including scaling Harriet Harman's house. 2 years ago, he achieved his goal.
I wouldn't have stopped, and I think that's come to that point when I realised that. there's no reason I shouldn't have contact and be able to parent my own child. The court had completely degraded me and made me feel absolutely useless as a parent. I felt that was the only option I had left, was to campaign in the way I did.
Fathers for Justice has staged a number of similar protests. It says the hopes of other fathers would dash today, as interim recommendations for greater equality were left out of the Family Justice Review.
Protesters from Fathers for Justice mount the front gate of Buckingham Palace and chain themselves to the railings. In a protest during the changing of the guard ceremony, the group called for the government to allow parents and grandparents equal access rights to children from broken relationships. Fathers for Justice hit the headlines during a similar publicity stunt in 2004, when a member dressed as Batman managed to climb up the front of the palace and remain on a ledge for 5 hours.
We've negotiated with the Conservative Party for the last 2 years. We've done everything, exhausted every conceivable avenue to try and create a fair and more just and equitable system of family law in this country, and it has failed. And we are reduced to having to chain ourselves to the gates of Buckingham Palace and put people to risk their life, limb and liberty in the pursuit of equality on the railings here at Buckingham Palace, because we have no avenue left to go.
They're also calling on people in the capital to recognise the importance of dual parent care in relation to the recent riots.
Child support should mean emotional and financial support, and it's so important in a city where we have massive amounts, 50% fatherlessness in black communities, where gang culture is absolutely rampant, because children are forming their families on the streets. They're forming surrogate fathers with criminals, drug dealers, etc. This touches everybody. It's not like animal rights or something else. This is an issue that touches every single person in the capital city of this country. And there's so few of us prepared to actually get up and stand up for what we believe in. I'm a businessman in London. I've got a business in Covent Garden. This is how strongly I feel.
The group are now in their 10th year. They're most recognised for their campaigns in novelty outfits on iconic landmarks.
Today we're bringing the message home, and what better place to do it than outside Britain's most famous home, Buckingham Palace. And the message is that the family courts in this country are state-funded cage fighting, pitching parent against parent.
But today, as the band played on, the police moved in.
I'm here to inform you that that this assembly is unlawful.
The protest would end peacefully with just the one arrest, but the organisers warn if politicians continue to ignore their concerns, they won't stay silent for long.
Office for Justice!
Nick Thatcher, London Tonight, Buckingham Palace.